I woke up about 4 o'clock in the morning and I felt like I was breathing, trying to breathe underwater. It started in my abdomen and I could not bear the pain.
4 days after giving birth to her second child, Joyya Thomson experienced the most terrifying night of her life.
It heard gurgling in my ears and it felt like I was trying to breathe underwater.
Joyya had also gained an excessive amount of weight, especially in her legs and feet.
I knew that something was horribly wrong. So I was trying to decide if we needed to call 911 and have the ambulance come pick us up, or if we could make it in the car. And I chose that it would probably be best if we just get in the car and go, because I felt like I was fading very quickly. I remember listening to my heartbeat and it just felt like it was struggling, just every single beat, just it wasn't working right. I just thought something is wrong with my body and I'm losing life right now. I could actually feel myself losing life. When I first got into the ER, they could tell that I was having trouble breathing, and so I was admitted right away.
The doctors performed several tests. The diagnosis, congestive heart failure. But they didn't know the cause.
When I was in the hospital, I was just trying to stay calm because I felt like I don't think they can help me, Anna, and all the tests that they were doing, and they weren't finding an answer, I felt. So I was just trying to stay peaceful because I didn't want to panic in my last moments. So I was just trying to just continue to just feel the peace of God and just trust Him throughout it all.
While Joyya's husband David was taking care of their two children, Joyya called her mom.
And I said, "Hey, Mom, you know, it's Joyya." And she's like, "Well, what's going on? What, you know, are you okay?" And I said, "Well, I'm in the hospital and I don't quite know, you know, what's going on, but I just wanted to give you a call so that, you know, you could just begin praying and just make sure everything's okay." And she said, "Okay." But at that moment that I was on the phone with her, the doctor came in to the room. And I said, "Well, Mom, can you hold on for a moment?" And I didn't place her on hold. I just put the phone down in my lap. He came and he sat down and he said, "You know, Joyya, you're gonna have to have open heart surgery. We're gonna schedule for emergency open heart surgery. And that needs to happen right now."
And then I heard the doctor say to her that she had torn a valve in her heart and that they were going to have to they were going to have to fly her to the Seattle hospital.
"We're going to do one last test, and we think that there's a tear in your heart and in the valve of your heart, and we're going to try to go in and repair that today." And he's explaining to me that I'll be on medication the rest of my life, and I won't be able to breastfeed my child, who's only 4 days old at this point. And the news that he was telling me was devastating. He says, "Okay, well, we're gonna do one last test, and then we're gonna come back and get you, and we're gonna transport you so that you can have your emergency open heart surgery." And I said, "Okay."
Then the conversation ended, and Joyya got back on the phone, and she says, "Did you hear that?" And I said, "Yes, I did."
And so we made a plan, and I said, "Okay, Mom, we have about 15 minutes before they're back in here to do my next test. We need to pray. I'm gonna call my pastors. You call who you need to pray, and we'll go from there."
So we hung up, and I got down on my knees by my bedside. And I got the phone, and I called the 700 Club, and this is what I said: "All I need is somebody that will believe God with me, because I already believe that God can heal her body."
Joyya had the final test, an echocardiograph, before her surgery. She waited nearly an hour for the results from her doctor.
He says, "Well, I don't know what happened." And I said, "Okay." And he says, "Well, we don't see a tear in the valve of your heart." And I said, "Okay." And he says, "So you don't have to have open heart surgery and you're getting better. And I've never seen this before. We don't understand why it was so bad and why you're getting so much better this fast." And I just remember thinking, "Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God." Because I realized He healed my heart. And we talk about a lot about God being a heart surgeon, and he's able to do heart surgery. But we talk about that in an emotional way. Oh God, please change my heart. But to know that God can change my emotional heart and that he can change my physical heart, that he literally did heart surgery on me, was miraculous.
Today, their daughter Jordan is 3, and their son Isaiah is 1.5.
It was just a privilege to just be able to watch them grow up, watch them, you know, play and learn how to read and learn their numbers, and just to be a part of those moments, seeing Isaiah walk and hearing his first words. And when I was in the hospital, I didn't think that I would have that opportunity. So to see my baby boy growing up and to see my baby girl, it's a blessing, and it's something that I will always treasure. Every breath that I take, I treasure. And I'm so grateful.